दोस्तों सब्सक्राइब करें हमारे चैनल स्मार्ट स्टेनोग्राफर को और लेटेस्ट नोटिफिकेशन के लिए बेल आइकन को भी जरूर दबाएं।
स्टार्ट सर, आई कम टू द सेकंड अमेंडमेंट बिल। हेयर द ऑनरेबल मिनिस्टर वांट्स टू मेक एन इम्प्रूवमेंट। आई वेरी वेल अंडरस्टैंड इट एंड टू सम एक्सटेंट इट इज़ वेलकम। He wants to cover an employee who has interrupted service and that interruption in service being created as a result of his absence without leave from service. The amending bill proposes to include this interrupted period of service of such an employee within the meaning of continuing service for the purpose of payment of gratuity. This much I welcome, but I would like to point out to the Honorable Minister that regarding 240 working days, the ambiguity is still there and the day may not be far off when the Supreme Court may interpret it in another way and you may have to come with another amending bill before the House. So that ambiguity should have been cleared by you. Here again, I beg to submit the Honorable Minister makes a provision which is entirely detrimental to the interests of the worker working in the factory or in some other establishment. Sir, I would like to draw the attention of Honorable Minister. Of course, he knows everything what is contained in the bill, that on page 2 of Payment of Gratuity Amendment Bill 1984, it says not being absent, in respect of which an order imposing a punishment or penalty or treating the absence as break in service has been passed in accordance with the standing orders, rules or regulation, etc. Here again, an unscrupulous employer, the number of whom is not small in our country, of course may take advantage of this provision and for some reason or other, even on flimsy or false ground, may impose a break in service of an employee every 4 years and thereby deprive the employee of his legitimate claim of gratuity. So this provision should not have been there, and I would submit to the Honorable Minister that the entire stipulations within bracket in this section 2A should be deleted for the workers working in factories if we want to do something better for the workers working in factories and some other establishments. Madam, I would like to submit that the Payment of Gratuity Act is now about a decade, more than a decade old, and this act seeks to provide a tiny dose of social security to working population. Further, I would like to draw the attention of the Honorable Minister to the fact that the working of this act, the experience of the working of this act, the Payment of Gratuity Act 1972 for the last 12 years has not been too much success. There are certain drawbacks, flaws and lacuna in the Payment of Gratuity Act 1972, and with these drawbacks and flaws, the act is becoming less meaningful to the workers for whom this act is meant. I would like to mention just a few of them. There is a provision that each worker is entitled to get gratuity only after he has completed 5 years of service. Why should there be this legitimation of 5 years? Let us take an example. Let us say a worker becomes disabled after 3 years of service. What will be his position? The demand of the working people is that such as person should be paid gratuity for the period of service rendered by him, so that with this gratuity amount he may be able to sustain himself for some days or for a month or two. You should, I submit, at best bring down this period of legitimation to 1 year of service, because 1 year's duration of service is, I think, quite sufficient to assess or gauge the performance of a worker or employee working in a particular establishment. Then again, madam, there is another drawback which lies in the principal act, namely the Payment of Gratuity Act 1972, that is, the gratuity amount of a worker is not adequately protected. Therefore, I would suggest that such a measure, such a statutory measure, should be brought forward by the government, which will enable the gratuity money to be adequately protected. There has been a constant demand from different sections of the workers that a gratuity fund should be created like the provident fund, with this difference that in the gratuity fund only the employer will be required to deposit his portion of the money. This fund should be kept quite apart by the employer for the payment of gratuity, and under no circumstances the employer shall be allowed to use the gratuity money for his own purpose. Such an arrangement should have been made in Gratuity Act. Now, there is another thing, madam, which I would like to point out. Under the present provision, an employee is entitled to gratuity if he works or serves in an establishment which has at least 10 employees. Initially, at least, you have made an amendment that initially it should be 10. That is not fair.